The family of a former Dondale detainee who told the Royal Commission he was stripped with a knife have dismissed the Northern Territory Government's interim response as a disappointment which doesn't deliver justice. Kenny Rogan's family is particularly disappointed no one behind youth detention abuses is facing sanctions as a result of the commission.
No, 16. Kenny Rogan has been out of trouble and youth detention for 2 years, benefiting from the support of coaches at his local AFL club.
When Kenny first came here last year, Kenny probably put about 2 or 3 words together on most trainings nights, but now he's really a part of the leadership group.
Kenny Rogan was 10 when he first went into Dondale for setting fire to a motorbike. He told the Royal Commission there he was stripped with a knife and isolated for long periods. He served more time for riding in stolen cars and breaching curfews. As a teenager, he came out withdrawn and behind.
Being out of school, those very important high school years, definitely going to have effect on him. So he's obviously got a lot more work to do than a normal youth that's had a pretty sheltered life.
The commission determined boys of his age shouldn't be in detention. It recommended the age of criminal responsibility be raised from 10 to 12, and no child under 14 be detained unless they've committed a violent crime.
Locking youths up in these detention facilities is affecting them mentally, which is only going to turn them into hardened criminals, and then affect the community which we all live in, you and me.
But aware of community anger over youth crime, the Territory Government has only given these and other key recommendations in principle support.
What we want to do as we go through a process of law reform is to make sure that we've got the right supports in place that will support police in absolutely keeping focused on community safety as well as getting a good response for those children who need it.
Kenny Rogan's family want to see the recommended funding for youth diversion programs. They're particularly disappointed detention abuse allegations have led to no sanctions for frontline staff or their political masters.
The NT government have shown us by not charging anyone still to this date, just sending a clear message that if you're in a position of power, you have the free rein.
The police say of 2 cases referred to them by the Royal Commission, one has been dismissed and the other is still under investigation. They say a review of 10 years of old abuse allegations cases has found nothing was missed.
We have had a major change in our executive. Their leadership at both the centres has changed significantly.
Many of Kenny Rogan's teammates also come from the tough suburbs of Palmerston.
And we give them all the same support. And with a bit of a support and a bit of love and a bit of care from everyone, it really makes a difference for these kids.
First-hand experience of what investment in young people can deliver. Jane Bardon, ABC News.